टुडे ब्लैक 19 सब्जेक्ट सिविक्स टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अबाउट द टॉपिक ह्यूमन राइट्स एंड द यूएन स्टूडेंट्स नेक्स्ट यू लर्न द एम व्हाट इज द एम ऑफ इन दिस लेसन एक्सप्लेन द रोल्स ऑफ द नेशनल ह्यूमन राइट्स कमीशन एज इन्फ्लुएंस्ड बाय इंटरनेशनल कन्वेंशंस एंड why we need to have a human rights commission individual states students next you learn the keywords today keywords are atrocities commission convenient civil procedure code students next you think the question how do you think human rights are protected did you know students yes There are laws in place to protect human rights, but there is also a court to make sure those laws are enforced and protected. This is known as a human rights commission. Students, next you see the picture. What can you identify in this picture? This picture is UN Declaration on Human Rights. That is the common rights of the human. They are assembly, association, movement, religion, speech, information, press, thought, education. These are also the basic rights of the human. Students, I ask some question. What does the National Human Rights Commission do? What are its functions? Did you know students? Yes. The protection of human rights applies to all countries. On 16 December 1966, the UN adopted Convention on Economic, Cultural and Social Rights and the International Convention on Civil and Political Rights. In 1993, the UN held a World Conference on Human Rights. At this conference, they developed the Vienna Declaration. At the same time, on 12 October 1993, a National Human Rights Commission was formed in New Delhi. What are the functions of human rights? There are more functions. One by one, you learn. First, examination of violations of human rights review of protections provided by the constitution study of treaties and international law and making recommendations for how to follow it promotion of human rights research education of people about human rights support of organization that work with human rights students next you learn the table national human rights commission reviews laws that harm human rights helps to stop police violence and forms of assault handle discrimination cases submits an annual report to the government which parliament uses to make decisions in the National Human Rights Commission. Students, next you learn the case study. So listen carefully, okay? Madam, we are honored to have you here today. We would be interested in knowing what the Human Rights Commission in India does. Yes. It is very important work that we do. We review laws that may harm human rights help to stop police violence and forms of assault and handle discrimination faced by the so called lower castes women and children this is a great deal of responsibility you have how do you make sure the government listens to your ideas true we have all the power of civil court under the civil procedure code we also submit an annual report to the government and then the Parliament decides upon what they will do as a result of the report. Students, I asking some questions. Listen carefully. Okay. According to Mrs. Iyengar, what does the National Human Rights Commission do? How does the Human Rights Commission influence the government? Did you know, students? Yes. The National Human Rights Commission reviews laws that may harm human rights and handles discrimination faced by the lower castes, women and children. The National Human Rights Commission submits an annual report to the government and the parliament makes decision based on it. Students, next you learn the State Human Rights Commission. Within India, some states also have their own Human Rights Commission. The Human Rights Commission of Tamil Nadu is located in Chennai. The commission looks into local violations of human rights. The governor appoints a chairperson and other members of the commission based on the suggestions of a committee. Students, that committee is made up of the Chief Minister, the Speaker of the Legislative Assembly, the Minister of the Home Department of State and the opposition leader in the Legislative Assembly. Students, the State Human Rights Commission sends an annual report to the state government, which is then submitted to the state legislature for further action. The human rights courts also function at the district level. Violations of human rights cases are also cured at this level. A public prosecutor with 7 years or more of experience served as the judge. Members of the State Human Rights Commission can be removed from their position by the governor. Students, I explained the case study. Listen carefully. Okay. Revathi works in a factory in Chennai. She works very hard and is good at her job. Another employee at the factory, Prasad, has the same amount of education and training as Revathi and is also good at his job. In a recent conversation with Prasad, Revathi learned that Prasad makes 15,000 per month while she only makes 9,000 per month, even though they work the same number of hours and have similar responsibilities. In taking with other women at the factory, Revathi discovered they make the same amount she does. Revathi recently told her employer that she is going to have a baby and will have to make maternity leave. Her employer threatened to fire her. Revathi decided with the other woman at her office to take her case to the State Human Rights Commission. The commission decided to the labor practices were unfair and forced Revathi's boss to raise her wages and grant her maternity leave. Students, what will we learn in this case study? Did you know, students? Yes. Students, I asking some question. So listen carefully. Okay. What type of work does Revathi do? What two problems does Revathi face? Did you know, students? Yes. Students, Revathi works in a factory. She makes less money than Prasad, her co-worker, who does the same job, and her boss threatens to fire her when she asks for maternity leave. Students, and the next question, what does she decide to do about her problems? She takes her problems to the State Human Rights Commission along with other women in her office. students, finally just review the human rights class. Okay, what are the five categories of human rights? They are civil rights, political rights, economic rights, social rights and cultural rights. These five categories are classified into two groups of rights, which can be found in the Universal Declaration of Human Rights, that is UNA, adopted in 1948 and were laid down into legally binding international instruments. The International Covenant on Civil and Political Rights, adopted in 1966, and the International Covenant on Economic, Social and Cultural Rights, rights in 1966. Students, you learn the UN Declaration on Human Rights and National Human Rights Commission, finally State Human Rights Commission. These are also the important human rights of the human. Okay, students, what are the civil political rights of the human? They are life, liberty and security, freedom from slavery and torture, right to own property, right to be involved in politics. These are also the civil and political rights of the human. And the next, socio-economic and cultural rights of human are, say for example, equal pay for equal work, right to work, right to education. These are also the example of socio-economic and cultural rights. Students, what do you think is the most important role of the National Human Rights Commission? Why? Some might say the most important is reviewing laws, because they are the foundation of society. And then next, State Human Rights Commission depend on two types. All human rights violations, why it exists, gives more power to the state. Finally, thank you students, you observing the video and do the outside. Okay.